there on the bar. Loud, ain't it?
Throw that thing in the toilet. All right, welcome into the Dupont Show right here on what's today, Thursday?
All day long.
All right. You listen to us on Alabama 100. Go to CKF FM, Alabama 100, FM 100.7. Also, WOTM TV 21, and YouTube, Facebook. And we're all here today, and everybody's happy. We got another drummer tonight, but we're going to find the right one, ain't we, Wayne?
He's coming. I believe we got him tonight.
We got one. Wayne, do us a song.
Here's one by request last night. Some Freddie Fender. A little thing called Made Him a Star here. Wasted days and wasted nights. I have left you behind. For you don't belong to me. Your heart belongs. Why should I keep loving you when I know you're not true? And why should I call your name when you're to blame for making me blue? Don't you remember the day that you went away? I was so long, cried for you only, my love. Why should I keep loving you when I know you're not true? And why should I call your name when you're too late? Making me blue. Ladies and gentlemen, the boys in the band.
Wayne, who are you? you pulled that one off there.
Freddie Fender.
No rehearsal or nothing. You ain't even knocked
right
that
on
out
in there and knocked it out of the park.
That's what you call
home
a pro
run.
Right there. A pro right there.
I'm a professional, you know. And then what they told us, he's a professional.
A couple come here and said, they were pros.
Pros.
I said, I wish we were pros.
I do, too. We're the most perfect imperfect
show on earth.
On earth. There it is.
That's pretty good. That's us.
That is a good slogan. You started off with it, and we've hung in there. And
we've
been loyal. We've
been
loyal to it, you know.
Yeah. When we get perfect, we'll change the most perfect show on earth, but we ain't got there. It's been over a year. We're going to work on it.
Like me and Randall, when we get fat, we're going to go on a diet.
Exactly right.
All right, Randall, do us a song.
It's old Ronnie Millsap, y'all.
Charlene from Sylacauga said, "Don't worry about me." We talked about that.
We
you
sure did.
Get that now,
I got it.
You
coming.
Got it now. I'm gonna give that to you. Don Farmer, good afternoon to y'all, and have a wonderful evening. Let's see what else we got. Edmund Willington, White Lightning request for me, Mom, and Charlie. Love,
oh, yeah.
Love y'all dearly. Thank you, sir. Scott White from Jasper Trudy. You remember old Trudy, don't you?
Call up.
On the telephone.
Oh, that's right. It is cell phone. Call up Trudy on the cell phone. I'll do that.
Good, White. Good evening, guys. Sounding great. Hope Willie is feeling better. We hope he is, too. And how about some Waylon Jennings?
Yeah.
We can do some Waylon. Somebody going to do something. Benny Leverton, I know they will. I'm going to let them do them as they can remember. Good evening, everyone. Benny Leverton and Sharon Johnson. Good evening from Gunnersville, Alabama. I told her there's some good. I fished there when I was a kid, man. Me and my mama.
Good eatings up that way, too.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Yeah, they got. Had that steak up there, you know. We went up there and
you can eat.
If you eat all of it, it's free.
Yeah.
Travis Younger, a guy that played bass for you, we took him up there. Man, we knew we had it. So they came out and it's 64 ounces, I think it is.
That's nothing.
Eat that in the trimmings. And they asked him, they said, how you want it cooked? And he said, well done. They said, hup, that's a foul. We can't cook one well done. It cooks too many of it, you know. He said, I tell you what you do. Let's up this thing. I'll eat two of them if you'll cook them both well done. He ate 126 ounces. The salad, everything was free and broke all records at the Vermani, I think it was.
Valmani.
There it is. But old Travis Younger there, one of these, he was a fine
player. He's the same one. Yeah, good brother, man. Yeah, bass player. He's the same one that went to work at the Detroit Tigers. With Tigers, a stadium there, and they had him on hot dogs. And
had a rain.
And started raining as soon as he got his hot dogs, and he had to hide under there. He ate them. How many was it, Wayne?
Well, they start you off at 75, and he turned one hot dog in and didn't sell none.
Didn't sell the
first one. So in a period of, it was over an hour or something, 74 hot dogs. They put him over souvenirs the next day. He sold bobbleheads for the rest of his years there. But that's a true story. Ate three buckets of, I want 100 off of this, three buckets of Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Yeah.
Three buckets now.
And I carried
every
him
bit
up.
Of it. George knows him. I know it is, but it's a true story.
They carried him up to Chinese restaurant up there in Oxford. Yeah. Him and Ham. And they finally quit bringing. They bring a thing of chicken out.
Yeah.
And they just get the whole tray and go back to the table and eat it. They said, come back no more, buddy. Y'all don't come back no more.
Don't bring this guy back, ever.
So we had some eaters in the band back then, anyway.
Yep. It was all of us. D looked up there one day. We was practicing. He said, I've hired a football team here, man. And me and big old Allen and all
everybody.
Of them. And we was. And we done fattened up like old pigs that day.
Had a couple of girl singers.
Well, I tell you what. We did that. But I ain't calling them fat.
No.
But, no.
Tim
we had some good times. Good times.
Tim Fugit. All right. Tim Fugit.
She asked me where I was from. I said somewhere you've never been to, little town outside of Knoxville, hidden by some dogwood trees. As she tried talking with my accent, we held hands and waded into that blue water. She left her flip-flops by my red wings on the beach. Yeah, but now I'm dodging potholes in my sunburned Silverado, like a heartbroken desperado, headed right back to my roots. Something about the way she kissed me tells me she'd love Eastern Tennessee. Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots. I said, let's go shoot tequila. So we walked back to that beach bar. And she said, don't cowboys drink whiskey? So we drank bottom shelf. She said, man, that sky looks perfect. And I said, girl, you've never seen stars like the ones back home. And she said, maybe I should see them for myself. Yeah, but now I'm dodging potholes in my sunburned Silverado, Colorado, like a heartbroken desperado, headed right back to my roots. Something about the way she kissed me tells me she loved Eastern Tennessee. Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots. I said, meet me in the morning, and she told me I was crazy, yeah, but I still thought that maybe she'd show up. Yeah, but now I'm dodging potholes in my sunburned Silverado, like a heartbroken desperado, headed right back to my roots. Something about the way she kissed me tells me she loved Eastern Tennessee. Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots. Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots.
Tim Fugue, good job, Tim. We got a guest up here tonight now. We're late model Mark from out here at Talladega Short Track. Now we got a lot of racing news, a lot of exciting stuff coming up this Saturday. So tell them about it.
Well, thank you very much, Dee, for having me for the second time. At least the sun's out this time, unlike when it was last time when it was like 5 o'clock in the morning. But I'm really happy to be here. Saturday night was supposed to be a two-night show, tomorrow night and Saturday, but with Mother Nature fouling things up, we're just going to race Saturday night. It'll be the second appearance of the Hunt the Front Super Late Model Series. We're very, very excited. This is a new series in the Southeast region done by the Joyner Boys down there in Florida. And it's going to pay a nice paycheck roundel like this one. $15,000 to win.
Can I borrow a car from somebody?
Well, heck yeah. I'll drive yours.
I'll see if Red let me drive his.
It's going to be a big event. And unfortunately, it's just going to be a one-day show. But I'm just glad we're going to go racing. This is our season opener. Talladega Short Track's been open since 1977. I've been announcing there for now 11 years, and I'm very proud to be announcing at that track, and I really, really, really enjoy it, and it's just a lot of fun. There's going to be probably somewhere in the upward area of 40 to 45 super late models, which is really good in 2024. We're also going to have the Crate Racing USA 604 late models that run for $2,000, the modifieds for $1,000, and the Hot Shots. Those guys run for basically peanuts and beer, and they're going to run for $750, which is pretty good.
Boy, they'll be coming all over the country.
Oh, yeah. I think we're going to have a well over 100 cars, and it's going to be exciting. I know some of the folks that I message here tonight from Talladega Short Track are watching, and you know who I'm talking about. You guys were all supportive, and we love this guy next door, and we love your club, sir.
Thank you, man. I know you was there Saturday night, wasn't it?
I was.
I think you stayed at the banquet, I believe.
Well.
almost.
That's until Randall gave me the boot thumb right there. Now we stayed until about 1:30, and myself and my wife, Jessica, we had a great time, and we love your club, and it's really cool. And you know what? When you go to your club, what's really neat, D, is you see racing stuff all over the place.
On the walls, yeah.
I mean, Red Farmer stuff and some of the NASCAR stuff. It's really, really cool, and I really enjoy your club, and I'm ready to go racing Saturday. There's nothing like the smell of racing fuel.
Whew. You know, disease, man. It's
900 horsepower. You've been doing it. 900 horsepower, the smell of rubber, your good friends, the people that think the same, and really looking forward to it. It's going to be very, very exciting. One day I want to get Randall out there and drive like a hotshot and do a couple of laps.
I'll tell you what you do. I'll bring him out there and you let me get him in that two-seater and I'll take him for a few laps.
There we go.
I ain't scared.
Oh, we'll see about that, but we got you.
I'm like that little kid be going, faster, daddy, faster.
You know, you're talking about Red Farmer a while ago. You know, Red, everybody kept coming back and somebody would have called me and they never called me. I know he had a stroke. And everybody said, oh, he's really bad. He's really bad. And somebody told me again yesterday. Jody told me the other day, Tuesday. Right. Said, man, he's really bad. So I called yesterday, and he said, hello, D, what are you doing? I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm working on my race car. And he did. He had a stroke, and he's doing real good. He was putting a transmission in when I talked to him. And he has to wear a patch over his eye because he had a stroke, and that eyelid won't close, so he has double vision. So he's done that, and he's got a little draw, and he's got a little limp. But by gosh, he's still working on that race car.
He is amazing at his age. I'm hoping.
Was he 91 or 90?
91 and change. I hope I'm breathing at 70, man. And that guy's just absolutely amazing. But, you know, for those of you who haven't been to Talladega Short Track in a while, there's been so many improvements on Adam Stewart and David Miller. Adam, if you're watching, thank you, boss. Love working for you. I mean, we've got new restrooms. They bought new tractors, new fencing, new lights. Everything is, it takes time and money.
Put up another wall in that other end of the racetrack, didn't
they? Well, that is.
Is it going on? Or
no, it's not going to probably happen until maybe the end of the year because it's he wants to get like new restrooms for the pits and
that's more important. They can run off that wall.
Concessions, you know, he's just
you need
so many
bathrooms.
I mean, where do you go, you know, nowadays, except for, if, you know, fancy super speedways like Talladega? We go in the bathrooms, they're air conditioned or they're heated, and you have attendants going in them. Even the Virgin Mary would like to go to the bathroom in our restroom.
That's
so
awesome.
You know, he's done really a great job, and we try to run an efficient program over there, and we've got the best lights in the state. It's on Talladega Short Track TV if you want to do live streaming. We really are making a lot of strides, and I just am very, very proud to work at what I call the number one dirt track in the state of Alabama.
So. I think so. I believe so. You know, that it's an amazing race. If you've never been to any folks listening, ever been to dirt track, you need to go because they put on a show, and they're coming from all over the United States. Now, the last race y'all had was the Ice Bowl.
Right.
Had almost 390-something cars.
Can you imagine that?
Can you imagine that? 396, 97 cars at one racetrack. You're talking about a race. Hot dog, a race.
Man, you can get your money's worth for that with the amount of cars, the amount of racing. And Saturday night, we're just going to have four divisions. So you're not going to be there till 1 o'clock in the morning, like some people think.
I hope you get amount of time to come to D4s.
Well, you're looking at one who's probably going to come over there. But we're just looking for a real good 2024 season, and I'm just excited as you can imagine. And I enjoy announcing at the track. It's a lot of fun. You see the same people are sitting in the same seats, families, kids, this, that, and the other thing. You know what's cool about Talladega D? Is you can bring your chair if you want to. You can bring a cooler with your own food and drink in it. And our concessions are dirt cheap. Even Randall could afford our concessions. He could buy a hot dog there.
It better be
I'll
cheap.
Make him alone if you need one to get one.
Yeah, exactly right. But it's a very affordable track.
Yeah, it's a great track. If you love racing, that's the place to go this weekend. And I guarantee you're going to have some fun if you go. And I'm going to be out there myself. I got to go see Red personally because me and him are really good friends. And I was so excited when he answered the phone. He was just like always, just happy, you know. I'm doing all right, D. I said, well, he said, I'm not driving, but he told me who it was. I think it's Scott or somebody.
He's had Lee Burdett drive his car. He's had Josh Atkins drive
Josh,
his car.
Josh, I think maybe Josh. You know, he offered me, and I said, well, Red, I'd probably tear it up. He said, well, I do. I said, yeah, but you have to work on it. I'm not going to be the one to tear it up.
You don't want to do that.
I haven't
anymore.
Been in one in 20 years, but I love it. Ain't nothing like it. It's better than any drug, any woman. I say I don't do drugs, but they say it's better than any drug, any woman, everything. It ain't nothing like racing.
You know, I've been doing this since, been going to the races since 1964. Been announcing for about 25 years, and I've been to like 160 racetracks, and I'm up to 2,232 races since I started going in 64. And when they come over the hill, especially the supers with the 900 horsepower, I get chill bumps on my arm. I never get tired of that stuff.
No, it's wild, man. It's
just like I never get tired of walking into your club and these boys are playing there. You guys got a great band.
Man, appreciate you coming by.
Thank you very much. And, appreciate
looking
it.
Looking forward to see you this weekend.
Yes, sir.
All right, we're going to do some more songs there. Late Model Mark, he's in there. You'll hear him on the microphone out there screaming. I bet he'll say D4s at least once. I've been in racing since I started out in 71, and me and a guy that I sponsored won over 1,000 late model races. He's in the Georgia Racing Hall of Fame and International Racing Hall of Fame, so he's passed away a couple years ago, but we've made our mark in racing. Of course, I raced, won a few races, had a heck of a lot of fun. Don't regret any of it. All right, who's up? Pam, you want to sing one?
Sure. All right.
We might get Bruce to do stroking here in a minute.
Maybe. He usually saves that for Saturday night.
Okay.
Late, in third set.
tell me I'm a land far away, where the tree of life in eternal bloom sheds its fragrance through the unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day, oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me I'm home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me I'm an unclouded day. Tell me I'm a king in his beauty there, and his smile drives their sorrows all away. And they tell me that no tears ever come again in that lovely land of unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day, oh, the land of an unclouded sky.
Judy Morton called in from up there, and Rosa says, happy Thursday. We'd love to hear Seven Spanish Angels watching from Rosa, Alabama. They always have a big watch party up there. That's what everybody in the country needs to do, have a watch party at your house and break out a couple of Cokes and some snacks and sit around and watch our show and sing along with us. That's the latest thing, Judy and Bruce. And D-Fan said, I'm glad y'all are all back good, safe, and sound.
Good to be
Sandra back. Greer, y'all sure do sound great. You are making me hungry. Please, please do wonderful tonight. Well, you need to just come on and eat at D4's tonight. We got meatloaf, pinto beans. I got it right here. Mashed potatoes and gravy, collards, squash, and cornbread tonight. And it's only $10. It's a big old platter. I promise you, you can't eat it all unless you Randall or Wayne.
That's she said only you way. Can also get jalapenos in your cornbread if you want it.
So. Senator Greer said, go ahead.
You can get jalapenos in your cornbread.
Okay. All right, Sandra Greer, so you sure do sound great. Y'all are making me hungry. Okay, I did it. Wonderful tonight. She wants wonderful tonight, if anybody can do that. Edmund Willington, drummer looks like he means business.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I am impressed. Y'all always have a master musicians on the show. Thank you so much. He appreciates that, too.
Bruce is a business
You just
man.
Got a promotion. Now you're master drummer. David Dover Sr., big cowbell ring to Angel Station. Here you go. Hold on. Let me get it.
There we go.
All right, there's a cowbell. Got too many things in my hand, but anyway. All right, cow for Angel Station, Alabama. All right, Thomas McGowan Jr., good evening, please. Play Sweet Home, Alabama. That goes on the list. Greta and White, late model Mark, they want to know when the first race of the season is, and that is April the 1st. And the weekend before that, they're going to have the practice session. So that's the official first race, unless something happens between now and then. Roger Darden from Raglan said, Dean Wayne, y'all doing such a great job.
Hey,
sounds
Roger.
Great. And that's it. All right, who's up?
I can do that. Seven Spanish Angels.
Seven Spanish Angels. There you go.
Yeah.
He looked down into her brown eyes and said, say a prayer for me. Threw her arms around him, whispered, God will keep us free. I could hear the riders coming. He said, this is my last fight. Take me back to Texas. They won't take me back alive. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another angel home. She reached down and picked the gun up and lay smoking hand in his hand. Said, Father, please forgive me. I can't make it without my man. And she knew the gun was empty. She knew she couldn't win. But her final prayer was answered when the rifles fired again. There was seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the fire stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Seven Spanish angels took another angel home. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. Oh, I believe they were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. Well, well, when the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was something from the throne. Oh, 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 seven Spanish angels took another angel home. Seven Spanish angels took another angel home.
We're going to get Mr. Tommy Sellers up here right after this a little announcement here. Bruce Morton called in, said, checking in from Rosa, said, a drummer got a name got, like that's got to be good. Old Bruce called in. Said, great job, everybody.
That's good.
All right. Angel Bird, listen, in Sherman, Texas. Boy, I love Texas. You know, was it last month sure. We had our big, we got. We
Texas
get,
was.
From Facebook, we get a number. That's the only one we really get a real count on. And Texas came in the number one over Alabama and everywhere for that one week or one month,
sure
something
did.
Like that.
1 week.
And got a lot of good listeners out in Texas.
Yes.
So we appreciate y'all listening. Tell all your friends, share it around and like us and share us and all that and help us. And we got a lot of big announcements, even more coming up. We're going to be on two more stations, one in Nashville, one in Muscle Shoals, and they got all the stream, major to stream, brand new networks opening up, and one's in Nashville. It's called American Country Network, so keep looking for that end of the month. And then the Muscle Shoals Network from Muscle Shoals, Alabama, is coming out, so we'll be on those two. So we're starting to reach out around the world and back. All right, let's see who else. Margie Fugit, your mama called in there, Tim, said straighten up.
Hey, mama.
Straighten up.
No, she didn't say that. Jamie Lover said, great job on seven Spanish angels, Randall.
Thank you.
Good job.
All right. We got a gentleman with us. Got his baby there with him. And Boo is always around.
You said gentleman?
Well.
You're not talking about me, are you?
Yeah, you.
Yeah.
Tommy Sellers. He's been singing. He sings all over the country sometimes. Yeah. You know, goes out on the road a little bit. And used to do it a lot when he was younger.
A lot younger. A lot when I was a lot younger.
Now you're just going all out in. He goes out to Texas a lot now. He's just going on air.
I got a lot of friends in Texas. I tell you what, they're great folks. They do think they are everything they got's bigger than it is out here.
Right. But,
I got a buddy out there that I think I may have told you about this before, but he's got a farm, and I got a farm in Clay County, and he called me one day and he was talking about his farm. He said, you know, I can get in my car and I can drive all day long. I won't get to the other side of my place. I said, yeah, I had a car like that one time.
Tell me, do us a song, man. That's a good one. Do us a song.
Riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning mail, 15 cars and 15 restless riders, 3 conductors and 25 sacks of mail, all along the southbound Odyssey. The train pulls out of Kankakee, rolls along past houses, farms, and fields. Passing trains that have no name, graveyards full of old black men, and the graveyards of the rusted automobile. Good morning, America, how are you? Say, don't. Danny Boy, it's in D. It's almost St. Patrick's Day, so why not? Danny Boy, the pipes are calling from Glen.
quick joke.
Great job.
A quick joke. Yeah, this I told you the other day. This guy, this girl called her daddy, had a flat tire. Said, get him to come, get him to come fix her flat. She said, he said, why don't you call your boyfriend? Said, I did. He didn't answer. Said, well, don't you have a spare? Said, yeah, he didn't answer either.
All right, Tom. Man.
Hey, Tom. I love, listen, I enjoy coming here.
Thank you, Tom. Appreciate you coming.
Don't be a stranger, buddy.
It's been a while since you've been here. Tommy Sellers from right over there, here on top of the mountain. What is that, Asheville?
Millerville.
No,
Okay. Hey, I was in... You know, folks don't know, a lot of people don't know where Millerville is. I was in Birmingham some a while back, and they asked me where I was from. I said, Millerville, and they said, I ain't never heard of that. They said, folks in Millerville ain't never heard of Birmingham, too. Hey, I love you, folks.
All right, thank you, Tom. You love you, too.
Thank you, Tom.
Yeah. All right, Wayne, you got one you got to do. It's, you said you're going to...
Don't worry about me. I can do that one.
Don't worry about me. All right. Chris gets back up there.
Okay.
Don't forget, our show is on Monday through Friday. And we come on at 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock. We're on Alabama 100.7 WCKF Radio, Alabama 100.7 FM. And my favorite show on there is the Tradio in the mornings. Tradio. If you want to sell something, buy something, give something away, call them. They'll come and get it. They'll buy it or whatever. And that's Alabama 100. Also, YouTube, Facebook, Roku, and WOTM Television 21 all over the state. Well, 85% of the state of Alabama, we're on TV around there. Soon to be on a Nashville network called American Country Network and the Muscle Shoals Network. So we're going to be streaming on out there all over the world. We're in all 50 states now. People have been calling in. I think we got, right?
Yes, all of them.
Got numbers. Yes. One of them's only had one, but some of them got 75 or 80. I mean, right. Texas is last month. I don't know about this month yet, but. We're rolling out there. So watch us and tell all your friends, call them up, have a watch party. We'll be going coming out to Colorado here real soon. We're going to stop on the way out. We may catch you on the way, and we're going to do a show on the way out at night. So live from the side of the road.
Hopefully that's the only reason we're on the side of the road.
Live on the side of the road.
Yeah, that's what we call it, live on the side of the road tour. Just pull over and put our antenna out and go after it.
That's right.
All right, Wayne.
Hold on 1 second, boys. You know when we drove up, DeRay met us out there and said, Daddy, I got a note for you here. And it was a note on the door that said, thank you so much for the hospitality and the friendliness of every one of y'all. Can't wait to come back to see you again. Looking forward to y'all coming to Colorado. This is Terry and Wayne. I hope I get this right. Is that right? Terry and are just Terry Wayne?
Terry and Wayne. That's what they told me, I believe.
Terry and Wayne, the last name is what I'm not quite sure of.
But them Colorado names.
Who is it?
Bain.
Okay, yeah, okay. Well, I guess that's it right there. Fine people right there, D, and they just want to thank you for all the hospitality. They parked their motorhome out there last night. Had a great
stayed
night.
With us. We were here, and Scott Van Baber, he was here singing really good. We love him. He's coming back again. Probably before we go out there. We're going to go out to Colorado, Eaton, Colorado, and do a big show out there in July. So y'all want to follow us along, you can. We're going to – seriously, I'm trying to figure out how to – we got the antenna stuff on the side of the road and do a show and get back and keep on rolling. All right, guys.
You know, you was bragging to them, too, D, about the racetrack. And so you invited them, matter of fact, to the dirt track over there. They almost stayed this weekend. They had some bad storms, but I think they went back. Maybe they'll come back for the big one. Okay. Don't worry about me for Sylacauga, Alabama. Here we go, boys. Don't worry about me. It's all over now. Though I may be blue, I'll manage somehow. Love can't be explained. It can't be controlled. One day she's warm, and the next day she's cold. And
don't feel ashamed. Yes, it might have been you. Oh, 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 love, kiss me one time, and there I'll go.
Honey, it's all right.
Don't worry about me.
All right.
I want you to be as happy as I when you first loved me. I'll never, never forget you and your sweet memory. It's all over now. Don't worry about me. When one heart tells one heart goodbye, one heart.
Tim Flowers said, y'all sounding awesome all the way from down there in Pell City, Alabama. Tommy Greer said, great job, guys. Thanks for all that y'all do for us. And Misery's late model Mark requests Amarillo by Morning by George Strait.
Okay.
And Brenda Bree said, please sing a gospel song, and I'm about to do one of my favorites, Little Amazing Grace. We do this a lot, but a lot of people like it. I saw Randy Travis sing it on YouTube the other day, and they were holding him up. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind. I see, 'twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious dear that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many, many dangers, toils and snares, I have already saved us for, and grace
when we've been there 10,000 years by shining as the sun. Sing God's praise. Then when we first begun, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. But now I'm found, was blind, but now I see, was blind, but now I see.
Ladies and gentlemen, D. Ford, great gospel music.
All right, Wayne, don't forget, coming up here in just a little bit, we're going down to the club down there and eat. We got about 5 minutes left on the show. Thursday nights down there is meatloaf tonight with pinto beans, mashed potatoes, and collards, and squash, and cornbread.
Yeah.
Don't nobody loaf it better than death.
It's good.
That's right.
Good meatloaf.
Meatloaf it. All right, I'm going down there to get me some here shortly, as soon as we get through. Who wants to do the last song? Randall, Wayne?
Randall, you got one?
There's some Elvis, the King, y'all.
Okay.
We may have to call it quits in the middle of this. We hope y'all enjoyed our show tonight.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right with you. That's all right, Mama. Anything you do, that's all right. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right, Mama. Anything you do, do it, George. You got that.
Bruce, we thank you for filling in for us tonight. You did one heck of a job over there. Yep. All you folks out there, y'all take care of yourself. God bless all of y'all. Thank you for watching the show. You make us, and we sure enjoy doing it. We started this show last January, and our intention was to play some good country music, some good old gospel music. And we try to do your requests. We don't get them all sometimes. We got them backed up here, but we're going to have an all-day practice session here one day real quick.
Get them all again.
And get them all one day. Learn them all. Then we don't have to round them up about once a month.
There you go.
We'll learn about 100 songs that day, won't we?
We're about 100 behind. I'm serious.
We're behind.
Y'all, it's unreal.
Come in about daylight and leave about daylight the next morning.
That's the way you do it.
That's the way you do it. Used to do it that way in my younger days.
Yeah.
I don't know if any of us can hold it anymore. We hope you enjoyed the show. We're going to call it home. Good night. Thank you all for joining. Join us tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. Get here on TV, Roku, Facebook, YouTube, radio, Alabama 100.7 WCKF Radio up on the mountain, FM. Also, WOTM TV 21 and YouTube, Facebook. A lot more streaming devices coming up here real soon. The next 15 days, 14 days, you'll be able to get it on just about any streaming device around the world. Hey, y'all. Bye-bye. We'll see y'all tomorrow night. There's that cowbell again.
There you go.
Woo! Yeah.